What's going on, guys? My name is Michael Hicks. This is my first garage build and garage update. Yesterday when I bought this 21 CRF110, and today when I bought this full mod 50. Ended up getting hurt at Atlanta 2 Supercross, messed up some ribs, so we're gonna lay low for a couple weeks. Back there, I have a ton of parts for the 110. And for the next couple weeks, we're gonna put those on and get a build going.
You guys all know what this bike looks like. But this bike, this thing is bad. It is a Billetwear 1 Plus frame on a Billetwear swing arm. Has an eye shock on it, Marzocchi whole front end, and then a Parada 140 motor. That bitch screams. But I estimated this bike cost about $4,000 to build, and I just got it today and bought it for a steal. Yeah, I've been wanting to do a YouTube build for a long time. I built these two over the winter time. That's actually my first ever dirt bike frame on a Parada 90 motor with some upgraded suspension. Stuff's just too stiff. That's kind of the reason I bought this bike. I wanted some better suspension. But yeah, it's just a stock KLX with just some stuff painted. I have a BBR swing on for it, but it's got the stock forks on it right now. So I just have the stock shock on it. But yeah, back to this bike. Rode this up and down the street once. But before I even got the bike, I ordered all this stuff for it. And it also got the PPK graphics and the plastics. But yeah, you guys see, this thing's sick. I like this a lot. PC triple clamp, BBR skid plate, PC pipe. Got all kinds of little stuff, you know. But dampening rods, stiffer spring, got the peg bar, the YZ pegs, TPK bars, and the BBR swing arm. So yeah, without further ado, let's start tearing this thing down.
Yeah, so just a little update, got the jump fence almost off, about to put the PCs on. I don't have rims, I don't have spokes, and I'll probably do that later. And then dampening rods and springs, probably do that later this week. But for now, I'll just put as much stuff as I can on, and I'll show you guys a little update once I'm done.
Just wanted to show you guys these triple clamps. These things are awesome. So you can either, it's got two holes, you can have your bars like that, or you can turn it, puts them a little bit more forward, or you can put them back in this hole and do vice versa. Just next level thinking. Definitely recommend these. Here is another reason I suggest these triple clamps. I put them on, and now I have that much more travel that I can do on the suspension, even with the stock. So once I put the dampening rods and the springs in there, it'll be even taller. So that's sick.
Alright, first step in putting the BBR skid plate on, take your pipe off. Honda did not drill this out for a bolt, so you gotta do it yourself. BBR has a really good video on YouTube explaining it, but I'm just gonna drill this all the way through. So once you get the hole drilled all the way through, take your little tap tool and you just tap it. All right, just got the skid plate on, the Pit Bike and Destroy foot peg, and then I just put the PC on. Let's see how she sounds. full mod 50 all tore down. Got the motor over there. I ordered fork seals for the forks, and I'm gonna put new oil on them. They've been leaking oil, and they're real springy. And then I have a swing arm, Kalex hubs, 65 front hub for this actual pit bike that I'm gonna get Cerakoted bronze. Swing arm, the subframe, the Honda side cover, some other little hubs and stuff, rim. I'm gonna get all that powder coated and Cerakoted. All right, guys, finally got all the parts of my pit bike, and I'm pretty pumped on it. We got the Faster Minis wheel spacers front and back in red. The PC triple clamps got two adjustments, and I can turn these blue clamps around. Highly suggest them. Got the DBK bars, the BBR throttle cable, and brake cable. This is a little bit finicky. I don't know. It's like, comes a little bit loose. I might just cut it off. It'll be fine without it, but definitely you need those if you get tall bars or triple clamp. Then we got the black plastics for the number plates, DBK graphics all around, the BBR tall seat. This thing's pretty stiff. I like it a lot. The BBR tall seats for a KLX 110 were super soft. By the time you sat on them, it felt like a stock one. Then we got the PC pipe. Thing bolted up and sounds real good. Pit bike and destroy peg bar with the DRC YZ pegs. Then we got the sick 110's brake pedal. It fits real good into there. You cannot do the sick 110's brake pedal with stock peg bar because it hits and gets all bound up. But then we got the sick 110's kickstart eliminator and the Faster Mini's little cap. It eliminates counter pins, looks a little cleaner. Then we got the BBR swing arm. Faster Mini sticker. Again, there's the wheel spacer. And then I had an older chain guide from a 50 sitting around, so I used that. And then we got the Piranha, I think it's either Piranha or T-bolt shift lever. And then the BBR skid plate on bottom. I had to drill the other side like you guys saw, but bolted right up. I had the dampening rods and springs right here. I have not been able to put them. I don't have the right weight oil, so I should be able to do that in the next couple days. One thing I forgot that I had was the MBMX shift shaft brace. And I just ordered the MBMX sprocket guard, and it comes with a chain roller on it. Highly suggest it, because if you have this BBR swing arm, your chain's gonna wobble like this. With that guard, it's gonna have a chain guide, it's gonna sit right here, and it'll be just perfect. It's got the wheels off the CRF. Here they are. I'm gonna go ahead and get these all Cerakoted bronze. And then for the 50, I have a bunch of stuff here. I'm gonna get all this stuff powder coated black. All right, guys, finally got my stuff back from powder coating and Cerakoting. Got six hubs done and the brake covers. And that's the swing arm for the 50, the wheels for the 50, and the subframe for the 50, also the cover for the 50. And then I went ahead and got these done, and then I got these vapor honed. So now they look brand new. They were really rusted and someone painted them black, but look good now. Finally done with the 110 build, and I am pumped on it. It's been a couple weeks since I started it. The wheels took a little bit longer to get done, painted. Took about a week to get painted, and then had to lace them up the other night. But yeah, I am so pumped on it. It looks so good. Turned out awesome. The other day I went and rode it for the first time, and I love it. It's so much better than a KLX. The only thing I am complaining about is the stock shock. It's way too soft. I got the forks, all the dampening rods, and the stiffer springs, but that shock is just way too soft. I'm going to definitely have to get an Elka or an Air Shock. Maybe I might try one of those, but I don't know. But this thing is so sick. And I showed you guys this bike, the full mod 50. I went ahead and pulled it all apart. I sold the 140 motor out of it because I just don't like it. It's too fast. I got the swing arm powder coated and the subframe powder coated. It actually unbolts off this frame. I went ahead and did fork seals and new oil in the forks. Got the hubs done. I'm just waiting on some rear spokes. I got the front spokes. Just got to lace that up. And then I can go ahead and throw this together. So basically what I'm going to do is pull this 90 motor out of this build, put it in this bike, and then use some other little parts off this for this bike. And then I'm going to put my original 50, my first ever dirt bike motor, into this bike. It'll look just like this, just with a stock 50 motor. I'm going to go ahead and pull that thing all apart, split the cases, redo the whole motor. And so this bike will be back, and this full model will be all ready to go. All right, guys, thanks for checking out my first garage build, garage update. I will play some clips of me riding this bike the other day. I rode it on a supercross track, and then we rode some pit bike tracks and a little sand track. I got some GoPros of that. But yeah, thanks for checking it out. Like, subscribe, whatever. I don't care. Leave a comment what you want to see. I'll try to get you guys an update on the 50 build here soon, maybe a little YouTube video. But we're going to start filming some pit bike videos, kind of vlogish style pit bike videos, and hope you guys like it, and stay tuned. Ha ha ha.